starred you, but I don't want to sit and listen to you.
All right. Welcome everybody here to St. Thomas Aquinas High School here for the 810 Varsity Soccer Showcase here on 810varsity.com. Our matchup here in game number 3 of the day is between the Olathe West Owls and the Bishop Miege Stags. Olathe West coming in with a record of 11-1-0. Bishop Miege coming in with a record of 4-7-0. This, as I just said, game 3 of our day here. The first game, Lee Summit North took on Blue Valley North. Blue Valley North coming away with a 4-0 victory. A brace scored by... Jack Souter for Blue Valley North scored 2 goals in that match. And also Nick Blackford and Firas Batrash with goal number 4 to end that. And in our previous match, it was a... Thank you. It was a very good matchup between Lee Summit West and Blue Valley Southwest. Blue Valley Southwest glitting a late goal. A late goal by Michael Pauly to give Blue Valley Southwest the victory, the Timberwolves. And so we're getting set for our game here, Olathe West and Bishop Miege. Olathe West in the Sunflower League, coached by Matt Trump, and Bishop Miege, coached by Nate Huppy. As they are announcing the starting lineups here from St. Thomas Aquinas High School in Kansas City, Kansas. Sorry, Overland Park, Kansas. And we're about ready for soccer here on this Saturday afternoon, our 5 o'clock game of the 2 games here this evening. Our final game tonight is going to be the Dodge City Red Demons coming all the way from Dodge City, Kansas at 9-2-0. They take on St. Thomas Aquinas, the host of this showcase. And they are 10-2-0. The defending Class 4 state champions are those Bishop Miege Stags. As the lineups continue to be announced, Olathe West, as I mentioned, 1 loss this year. Blue Valley West knocked them off earlier on this season. Bishop Miege struggled so far this season, having some issues in a lot of games, but you just think about the schedule they do play. It's very, very... very difficult for the Stags of Bishop Miege. And so here we go, about ready to get underway here from St. Thomas Aquinas. Kickoff will be done by Olathe West on the field, on your screen here. Olathe West wearing the white uniforms with the blue numbers. And on the other side, Bishop Miege wearing the red uniforms with some blue sleeves and white numbers on the backs and the front. And we are about ready to get underway. 40-minute halves here on 810varsity.com. I'm Nate Kendall, partner on camera, Noah Bonner. And we're about ready to get underway here. Game 3 of 4 on 810varsity.com. And they come set the ball in the middle. And we are underway. Olathe West will start with it. Now swings it out wide on the wing. Cuts to the end. Now plays it back to the middle. And they will set up, have a little bit of a possession type offense. Now here to the near side, Olathe West number three. And Nico Lopez here on the he'll be on the right wing. I've played all the way to the left side of the left back, playing it forward, trying to find a middle pass. He does. Gonna swing it now to the middle. Luke High, now it's in the back. Beleza. Now he'll swing it out to his left back. Plays it into the middle. Now out on the wing. To the inside. Still fighting for possession. Ball will be kicked out. It'll be a throw-in for the Owls of Olathe West. Check that. It will be a corner kick. I said it crossed the end line, so corner kick coming for Olathe West. Early opportunity here, just a minute 15 in. Ball's played in. Be claimed by the keeper. Keeper, I believe that is number one, Matt Moeller. And then a turnover here on the near side. And now they're going to go the other way. Play it out wide to Lopez. Lopez, and it's turned over. Miege with the ball. Now plays it forward. But it'll be... So here we go. Now, near side. Or the far side. Plays it in the middle. Held up and taken away by Miege. Stags with the ball back. Now Hagen. John Joe Lopez. Now swing it. Now they play it in the middle. Flicks it out. Plays it here to the near side of Lopez. Now taken away. Now they're going back forward. And now back on the attack. Miege flicks it ahead to nobody. Now they'll head it back. Tried to head it forward. That was number 10, Diego Olivas. And claimed by the keeper for Olathe West. That's a double zero, Ryan Sauter. Now out wide. Looking for some offense there now. It's Lopez. Flicks it on and recovered by Olathe West. Now back in the offensive third. Kernow. Now out wide a foul. Be a free kick in a dangerous area for Olathe West. It will be at be out wide. Out wide, a opportunity here early on, just 4 minutes in for Olathe West. Cross comes in low and it's flicked away. Now they boot it out. And it'll be recovered by Olathe West. Sade Smotherman. Now back to the middle. Now back to Smotherman. Now he'll let it slide all the way to the near side. Now plays it ahead. Headed away by Real, but stays with the Owls. In the middle. And now trying to beat man with the dribble. And another foul. And another free kick coming. Another dangerous area for the Owls of Olathe West. And here we go. Another dangerous spot. And here it is in low, flicked up in the air, and it'll be claimed by Moeller. Matt Moeller claimed that one easily. Now we'll boot it up the field. To his lone man, lone forward up ahead. Now Miege gets it back. Flicks it ahead here to the near side. That's Garrett Hagen. Hagen brings it down. We'll drive in. And it'll be flicked back to him now in the middle. They got a man, but offsides. That's Diego Olivas. He's just about a yard offsides. And so the first real opportunity for Bishop Miege comes to nothing because of the offsides. And so Olathe West. And now West. Now they get it out here on the wing. Left back, they keep it there. And now Olathe West driving forward, cross inside, flicked on the back post, it's in the back of the net! Olathe West Owls have the advantage. Goal scored. Henry Kernow with the goal for Olathe West. And the Owls have the advantage, a slow rolling goal for the Owls. But it's good enough. 1-0 lead for Olathe West here in this 810 Varsity Game 3 of the Soccer Showcase here on 810varsity.com. Game 3 of 4. And so now Miege gets it back underway here. Now wide, it's going to roll out of play for a throw-in for Miege. Look to take it quickly, but they will reset it. And now it's out for a throw. Here's it. Far side now plays it up the wing. Miege has nobody in the middle, so it'll be headed back on, but recovered by Miege. Miege Velez. And now it's out wide and out of play for a throw for Bishop Miege. Down 1-0 are the Stags here early on. Just less than 10 minutes into this match. We got a goal from Olathe West. First goal scored in the first half of any, and now this is the third game. First goal in the first half of any of the games so far today. In the middle, oh, mistake made in the back, and it's going to be out for a goal kick for Olathe West. A stiff wind blowing here. In Overland Park, Kansas, wind blowing in the face of Olathe West, currently on the offensive side of the field. They got it back. And now taken away in the middle of the park. A foul. Go against Olathe West, free kick coming. Bishop Miege. That Olathe West has the 1-0 lead on a goal by Henry Kernow. Now they flick it forward. Now it's kind of bouncing around in there. Now rolls out and will be booted into the stands for a throw-in for Bishop Miege. Going to try a long throw into the box, up in the air. It was there for the taking, and a foul. They'll call a foul in the box on Miege, so free kick coming for the Owls. Keeper directing the traffic a little bit, get wide so he can play it forward. Sauter boots it ahead. But now headed on by Miege and now played into the middle. And now it's kind of bouncing around. Now Miege with it back. Fires it here to the near side, but it's recovered by Beleza. And now this ball will go out for a gold kick. Now out, an errant kick is out for a throw-in here on the near side. Now a long throw into the box. And Miege takes down what's to be a shot, and it's going to go out for a corner. First corner of the game for the Stags. A good shot. Artoni Velez with the volley. And now a corner coming. Miege taking it. Garrett Hagen, the senior forward. And he'll take it. Fire it on the near post. Nobody there for Miege, and it goes all the way through. Closest man to it on the backside is Victor Lopez, the sophomore forward for the Stags. And now a throw in on the far side. And now out. Didn't even throw the ball into play. Threw it straight out of bounds, so Miege will throw it in again. No. Yeah. So long throw in for Miege. On the far side, fires it in. Flicked on. Now Olathe West will boot it out. But staying in the attacking third. Out wide, nobody there. It'll roll out for a throw-in on the far side. Now they throw it in again up the side. Trying to get to it is Olathe West. And now it's booted out. Now throw it up, looking for Hagen. Now flicked out. It's number 24, Sage Smotherman. Smotherman. Here we go. Still. And now Olathe West fires it forward. A little bit of contact here on the near side, but no foul. This will go out. Oh, it'll stay. He'll keep it in. Beleza keeps it in and plays it back to his keeper. Now they'll reset it from the back. Plays it forward. It was Blake Peterson who had the ball. Now in the middle. Now in the middle, trying to play, and a push in the back would be a foul, so free kick. Bishop Miege. Miege with it, trying to jockey for the ball back, now into the middle. And now, going back the other way, Olathe West on the counter, up the left wing, cuts back inside, and too much of a touch, and now we'll flick it. Now substitution for Bishop Miege. Now we've got 24-40 left first half, and another sub set to come in for Bishop Miege, but they'll throw it in. And a turn on the far side, that's Olivas. Played out. Far side, another throw in. Now it's taken away in the back. Mistake made by the left back, but a foul. On the middle. Turn. Now Olathe West now plays it in the middle. Now turns in the box, fires a shot. And now they'll take a second chance opportunity, and shot goes wide. It looked like Matt Mulder had it covered at the far post. And so it'll be a goal kick for the Stags of Bishop Miege. Now a throw in for Olathe West. Down and now boom it back up the field with the wind. That ball will go way out for a throw in for Olathe West. Miege is trying to solve the defense of Olathe West. Has a very, very good shape for Olathe West. And now they'll play out on a counter. Here the near side. That's number 34, Nico Lopez. Lopez drives in on his left. Now he'll play it back across. Overshoots his man in the middle. Will they be able to keep it in? He will on the far side, and it'll be played out. It'll be throw in. And now a hard challenge and a foul. A couple guys slow to get up there on that far side. It'll be a free kick for Olathe West with 20:50 to play first half. Olathe West won, and they're going to blow the whistle to stop the clock. And now we'll play it in, into the middle. The ball bounced around a couple times, and now Miege has it with a chance to counter. It'll be a foul. A tactical foul there by number 6, Elias Eluze. And now they tried to take a quick free kick, but they lose the ball. Trying to get into the attacking third. Now they play it into the middle. Olathe West with it. Plays it back to midfield. Looks out to the left. Will play it to his left back. Now in the middle. And now another chance for Olathe West. We'll keep going back. Now he'll play it out wide. And Miege will boot it out. Miege playing with a lot of guys back. Actually, all 11 of their players are inside on their side of the field. And now Miege trying to counter quickly. The near side. Fought for and ball won back by Olathe West. In the middle. Now here the near side. Now taken away, trying to find Nico Lopez. Now Miege. Trying to break some space open. They try to play it up the wing. Nobody making a run for the Stags. And the Owls get the ball back. They have really possessed the ball for much of this first half. This little over half the first half, they've had the ball on their own side, on the Miege side of the field most of that time. Throw in Olathe West. They'll play it in. It'll be a handball. Handball on Olathe West. So a substitution coming for Bishop Miege. Be for one of their forwards here. Out goes Diego Olivas, and on comes John number 5, Jaden Lewis. Lewis here looks like he's gonna play here on the near side. Now they booted up the field, headed on again. And now a fourth header now, and Olathe West finally wins the ball. Play it here to the near side, or here in the middle. Now to the near side, going to get through to the right winger. Now play it into the middle. They're going to try to beat, stops and turns. Now out at the edge of the box. Going to drive to the right, look for a cross. Going to be a defender there, and they're going to keep the ball in, and it's going to be out for a goal kick for Bishop Miege. Good defensive play there for Bishop Miege to now goal kick. Now out wide. In the middle, number 10, Luke High, got stepped on in the middle of the field. It's kind of gimping, hobbling around a little bit in the middle of the field. But yet another free kick, one for Olathe West. Fire it on. Look back post, headed on. Flicked on, and it's going to be corralled by the keeper. Moeller ran it down. Ball got headed across the face of goal and got all the way through the back post. Nobody there to just, they just had to get a touch on it to get it into the back of the net. And now another attack. Plays it into the middle. Look through ball, and now be played out here to the near side. Be picked up by Lewis. Jaden Lewis spins and will lose it out of play. Jaden Lewis, a senior. What's he all doing there? He is teaching online. Outside the foot pass to the middle. Now they'll play it into the middle. Here, just under 15 minutes to play in the first half. Now here on the near side, plays into the middle, trying to find a forward in the middle. And Miege had about three guys around him in the middle, and that'll be out for a throw for the Stags. Substitution for Bishop Miege. Up in the air, Miege trying to, just as I mentioned earlier, there. As I was saying, Miege has kind of been pinned back in their own end of the field, being attacked most of this game. Now Lewis will take it away, but bad touch. And now a handball in near midfield. Olathe West free kick in the middle of the field. Now in the middle. Olathe West still. Finds a man. Now a turn. Look to shoot, but passes it off instead. Now headed back on. That was Johnny Munoz. Had a look at goal, but decided to make a pass instead. Try to be too unselfish, really. Now in the middle. Garrett Hagen plays it on to Lewis. Lewis trying to use his pace up the side. He'll get back to the ball. And the ball will be kicked out for a throw-in for Bishop Miege on the far side of the field. That'll be a long throw-in. Looks like they're setting up for a long throw into the box. Try to get ahead to it, get another goal, or to get a goal here in this first half. Tosses in. It's going to be now taken away. Going the other way with speed. That's Nico Lopez. Lopez has one man with him here on the far side. Stops and now plays it ahead. He's got his man. And now it'll be booted out. He had Munoz. Cross into the box. And now Olathe West will reset. I'll play it in on a through pass, trying to get to the byline. It's going to be now booted out for a throw in, now down near the corner for Olathe West. Now some substitutions coming. Substitutions coming for Olathe West. Four fresh bodies in for the Owls. Now throw in here, long throw into the box, headed out. And now he'll get it, but now. Now they're battling in the corner. Now Miege will get possession back. Pump it forward. Now headed back on for Olathe West. Fake shot. Back heel pass. On the edge of the box. And he is brought down at the edge of the box. on the edge of the box, very close to a penalty kick. And here we go. Dangerous area for Olathe West. Lots of bodies in the box. And here we go. Hand in the air, they're going to take it. Near post, grabbed by Moeller. Under 10, now he'll throw it out here to the near side. It's Jaden Lewis. Lewis showed some pace earlier against the defense. Now takes the ball, cuts it back to the inside, cuts on his right foot, continuing forward. Now just flicked away by the Olathe West defender. Now they'll continue. Olathe West with it. Now plays it headed on. And now back out here to near side to Lewis. Lewis, two guys around him, and Olathe West will get it back. Beleza with the good defensive play to regain possession for the Owls. Now, Olathe West. Here we're down under 9 minutes till halftime here on 810varsity.com. I'm Nathan Kendall with Noah Bonner on the camera for me in this game 3 of 4 in the 810 Varsity Soccer Showcase here from St. Thomas Aquinas High School. As I'll just run down while we're going here, run down the first match of the day, Blue Valley North, 4-0 victory over Lee Summit North in a game that was 0-0 at the half and turned into a 4-0 game by the end of the game. And now trying to get going forward. Spence plays it out here to the near side to Smotherman, and he'll fire looking for a cross into the middle that was crowd by the keeper, and was an easy catch. Game 2 of our day, Blue Valley Southwest knocked off Lee Summit West 1-0 on a late goal by Michael Polly, the center back, getting up on a corner. And now Miege showing some pace, flicks it here to the near side, looking for Lewis, Jaden Lewis. Now he tries another cross, and it goes awry and out of play. Goal kick and some substitutions for the Stags. This is our, as I was saying, third game of the day. Olathe West holds the lead 1-0 on an early goal within the first 10 minutes. Henry Kernow scored the only goal of this game early on in the match, and now a throw-in for Olathe West. And just to finish off what we're looking at the rest of this ball game, or the rest of the day, Dodge City Red Demons. They made the long trip from Dodge City here to Overland Park, Kansas, to take on the home team, the St. Thomas Aquinas Saints, here at the 7 p.m. kickoff. And now Olathe West back on the offensive here, 6:10 to play, first half. They play it into the middle. Now tried to look for a pass in the middle, be out for a goal kick for Bishop Miege. Now they're going to stop the clock. As a substitution for an injury, it appears on the far side. Number 7, Victor Lopez, will leave. And now they'll kick it back off. Now back going forward. Got another chance as Olathe West fires a shot. Moeller with another save. Matt Moeller gets down on both knees and crowds the ball. Pass was a little bit behind. It's a little bit behind the attacker there. Now going back forward. Munoz. Munoz still on the left. Fires a shot down low. It's in the back of the net. Goal scored for Olathe West by number 13, Blake Peterson. And that's a 2-0 advantage for the Olathe West Owls. Olathe West with a 2-0 advantage. Assist by Johnny Munoz for Blake Peterson's goal. Flicks it forward. And now it'll slide all the way through to the keeper in the back. Olathe West leads 2-0. Little over 4 to play first half. Owls 2, Stags 0. Olathe West has really controlled this match from the get-go here on 810varsity.com. Now out for another throw-in for Olathe West. Fighting forward, now cuts back inside, plays another good pass forward. Now sliding challenge, go out for a throw-in for Olathe West. Of our goals scored today, we've had now 7 goals scored on the day. Every single goal that's been scored has been scored against the wind. So Miege now trying to break that trend and get a goal going with the wind. It's like, as I said, 7 goals all scored against the wind tonight here from St. Thomas Aquinas High School. Now they're going to try to attack. Under 3 minutes to play here in this half. They're attacking forward. Running onto it now. The ball will be booted up in the air and will go out of play here to the near side. Be a throw in. Ismael Martinez on the field for Bishop Miege. Martinez, a sophomore. He's a little guy trying to show some pace, though, and he's going to run forward. Ball will be grabbed by Smotherman. Now here to the near side, flicks it back on in the middle. Scanning the field. Conroe. And now turn back over. Bishop Miege trying to just solve this Olathe West defense. They have struggled mightily to get really anything going on the attacking side of the ball. Here's, we got 1.5 minutes left, first half. And halftime's going to be a difficult one for Coach Nate Huppy. Coach Huppy is going to be looking for an answer at half. Down 2-0. We're here now at 1 minute to play. First half. And Olathe West trying to make it 3. Back in the middle. Olathe West still on the attack. 1 minute to play. Now they'll play it back out and kind of hold on to the ball, possess the ball here for probably most of this. Now another driving run forward, and now Miege is going to try to counter. Ball just kind of pinballing around. Ball was played deep, and now here they're going to fire it forward. Here with under 10 seconds to play. Headed on. They're going to go quickly. But Miege's defender just gets in the way with 2-1. And that's the half here from St. Thomas Aquinas High School. Our score here at the half, Olathe West 2, Bishop Miege Stags 0. And so we'll take a break for halftime here on 810varsity.com. Back after this on 810varsity.com.
Core Civic is proud to support Lansing Athletics. Core Civic is America's leader in partnership corrections, operating over 60 facilities in nearly half of all states. Learn more about Core Civic job opportunities at corecivic.com. You can apply for a rewarding position as a correctional officer, a nurse, or a school teacher, just to name a few. Your next career could be in corrections with Core Civic. Visit corecivic.com. That's corecivic.com.
Thank you. high school sports fans. Trent Green here, and when I want the latest scores and news, there's only one place I go, 810varsity.com. Live scores, features, brackets, and even watch games live on the laptop, phone, or mobile device. Watch the Lee Summit, Blue Springs, and Park Hill schools, Blue Valleys, Olathe's, Rockhurst, Miege, Lansing. The list goes on into Missouri and Kansas. And playoff broadcasts too, plus top 25, awards, and more. Check it out now, Kansas City's home for high school sports.
Gear up for Back to Sport at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
Today is a new day. A day we've been waiting for our whole lives. We've put in the work to get to this moment, to have this opportunity to come together as a team. Everyone knows KC is on the rise, but what they don't know is we're just getting started. Okay. Community America, powering the rise of Kansas City.
SUVs, nothing beats Honda. U.S. News and World Report's best SUV brand 4 years in a row, including the 2019 Honda Pilot, one of the millions of Hondas built here in America since 1982. Or the 2019 CR-V, a crossover car and driver calls a better value than the RAV4. And right now, get Pilot with 1.9% APR financing for well-qualified buyers. For more offers, visit kchondadealers.com today.
When it comes to painting the exterior or interior of your home, the decision is easy. Unique Painting, voted best in the Northland for 2 years running in 2018 and 2019. Unique Painting focuses on customers' needs and offers competitive pricing, going the extra mile to make sure customers are completely satisfied. In fact, when 810 Varsity needed a paint job this year, Unique Painting was the only phone call made. Visit anytime at uniquepaintingkc.com or call today at 816-500-7759. That's uniquepaintingkc.com, a proud supporter of 810 Varsity and Metro High School Athletics.
Thank you.
Welcome back here. So we're about ready to kick off the second half here on 810varsity.com at the 810 Varsity Soccer Showcase. Game number three of our day here today. Game three of four as the Olathe West Owls hold a 2-0 lead over the Bishop Miege Stags. Goals in that first half, both by Olathe West. One by Henry Kernow. He got the first one going in within the first 10 minutes of that first half. And then Blake Peterson with a shot there late in that first half to make it the 2-0 scoreline that we stand with right now. And so the Stags will start with the ball here. They will kick us off here in the second half as we are about ready to get underway here in game three. Okay, as I said, game three of four, one more left to go here on 810varsity.com as Dodge City made the extremely long trip. Dodge City made the long trip here to take on St. Thomas Aquinas Saints. Now Miege fired it forward and out for a throw-in for Olathe West. West is going with the wind this half. Bishop Miege going into the wind, now a foul on Olathe West. It'll go the other way here early on in half number two here on 810varsity.com. These two programs in kind of gone in two different directions. Now play it forward. And Sauter makes the catch there in the box. Flip it here to the near side. Number two, Abel Ambesi. And now play it out of the wrist to the right wing, Hagen. We brought down, but the ball will be out for a goal kick. Looked like a tough challenge there. West with it again on the attack, playing it forward. As I was mentioning, these two programs kind of gone in two different directions. Bishop Miege is the 4A through 1A state champion from last year. And Olathe West has kind of found their footing this season. And now sliding challenge out for a throw for Bishop Miege. Olathe West found their footing this year and are looking to be a force in 6A on the Kansas side. And if I'm honest, they look like they could be one of the favorites to win the state title in 6A. And Dodge City is over there too. They are on the opposite side of the state, as many of you watching probably know. Yeah, they're on the opposite side of the state. Now they'll fire it forward to Olathe West. And now flicked it on. Really good flick on. Kernow looking for a brace. Now flicks it into the box. It's played down. Bicycle kick shot. That'll be an offsides. The attempted bicycle kick was right down the throat of Moeller, but the offsides, and it will not, the shot won't even count. But wow, what an athletic effort in the box. And now the ball's bouncing around in the field, and now be grabbed again over by Moeller. Athletic effort the field in the box. Now on the attack, Olathe West shot. It is saved through the hands of the keeper, Matt Muller, but out for a corner and a blistering effort in the middle of the field. Trying to see what number that was. That was number 6, Elias Elus. And now a corner taken. Played on as a high floating corner. Go way out. Pat through the back post. And now the ball bouncing around. And now Olathe West has it back. Crosses, trying to play it into the middle of the field. And now it'll be on the... They play it on. And here is Sauter, who collects it at the edge of the box. Now we'll roll it out here to Smotherman. Now Ambessi back to Smotherman. Now he'll play it to his center back partner. That is Denton, Cameron Denton. And now Olathe West turns it over in a bad spot, but he'll win it back and play it forward. Now they're going to go on the counter quickly. They've got 4-on-4 break here. And now a good defensive play, but one back. That's Elus. Now to Curno. Curno into the middle. Hit it on! It's a goal! Olathe West with a third. And it's 3-0. Henry Curno's cross into the box. Headed on into the back of the net for Olathe West. Goal scored for Olathe West by number 9, Johnny Munoz, with the goal. Henry Curnow with the assist, and it's 3-0. Olathe West, and here we go. Now back on the attack, Olathe West. Here we go now, they'll flick it along. Little Bishop Miege trying to get something going on the offensive side. And that goal there scored is the first of the day with the wind behind the team. A very good goal scored there. And really, I mean, that play was made by Henry Curnow as he beat his guy up the wing and flicked it across for the header right in the middle of the field by Johnny Munoz to make it 3. And they play it back in. And Bessie flicks it on, but they will blow the whistle out. It'll be out for a throw-in. Hagen now flick it on. Here on the near side, Mauricio Salas had it here. Now Hagen will fire it on. Claimed out near the edge of the box by Sauter. Now in Bessie, back. It's Peterson out in Bessie up the wing. The left back has gotten way pretty far forward here for Olathe West. Now early half goal for Olathe West. And now back, pushed off the ball, but a foul called. And now Bishop Miege will have a free kick in their own half. Now foul, Olathe West free kick now. Now Peterson, Blake Peterson. And now they'll continue. And Bessie here on the near side will drive in and now fire it into the middle, but taken away. And Mie is trying to show some pace here on the counter. Plays it forward, nothing doing. Sauter sneaks it past the Miege player. Otherwise, he had an open goal behind him. Here we go, continuing forward. Step over, another step over, driving there to the, near the byline, but a grab in the box. They're not, I can see it from here, a shirt grab in the box. And a no foul given, the ball rolls out for a goal kick. They're going to continue pushing forward. Still a battle for the ball. Hagen. Garrett Hagen wins it back. Fighting forward. Now the ball will be booted out for a throw-in here on the near side. Down near the corner flag. For the Bishop Miege Stags. Looks like setting up for a long throw. Tony Salas. The senior will make the long throw. And there's the throw. Into the middle. Shot taken but deflected out. Really good play there to keep that ball from getting close to the back of the net. Now it's headed out. It will go out for a throw-in once again. And another dangerous area for the Stags of Bishop Miege. They need to find themselves a goal here. Now the long throw on its way. Headed on. Oh, and nearly. But it'll be taken out by Olathe West. They keep going. Shot fired, but well wide of the target. So goal kick coming for Olathe West. Twenty-eight minutes left in this ball game. Olathe West has the lead 3-0 on Bishop Miege. Now battling for the ball. Now the Miege still fighting. Diego Olivas. Now he'll play it out wide to Mauricio Salas. It'll be another long throw coming for the Stags of Bishop Miege. They've had some dangerous long throws recently. And I look for another one to be coming here from near the corner flag. The throw comes in, and it'll be claimed by the keeper. Long throw again by Tony Velez. And now they throw it out quickly. Be out on a quick attack. And they win the ball, but a foul. And the crowd not really loving it a whole lot there, but it was a foul. So now Miege had the free kick. They're trying to have the ball in the attacking third of the field for a little while, but they haven't found that breakthrough. They've had a few chances, haven't found the breakthrough, and now back on the attack looking for Kernow. But a good defensive play there in the back. And now a turnover. Up the wing, spins. Now Olathe West. Just kind of going to possess the ball a little bit. Now play it out wide on the right side. And now another ball in. Going to cross it in the air. Headed on into the middle. Shot coming in, saved. Matt Moeller with a diving save on a very good shot in the middle of the box. Kind of on the volley. And now they'll boot it high into the air. And now play it back forward. Miege, 25 minutes to find three goals to get back into this ball game. Really, and it starts with one. You need one good attack. Find a goal to give yourself a little bit of hope. But now a quick 1-2. Now another one. Now in the middle, turns and looks, trying to find another pass. And now they're going to go quickly. Miege trying to get the attack started. Now we'll flick it on. Salas trying to run onto it, trying to get to it, and now it's flicked out. And Olathe West maintains possession into the middle. Played on. And here to the near side, and Bessie showing a lot of pace here up this left side. And now a turnover. Trying to go quickly and get back. Olathe West, foul. They're going to stop the clock. It looks like it'll be a yellow card. A yellow for Olathe West. So a substitution has to be made now as can't catch the number, but he was given a yellow card for that foul. And so he'll go sit down now. So now a free kick for the Stags. Bishop Mie Stags from the EKL. Now the ball is placed down. He's going to take it. It's up in the air, into the box, headed on, trying to get to it. Sauter gets to it, and now we'll throw it out quick. They're going to try to hit on the counter. Really, in the state of Kansas, if you really want to have as biggest goal difference as you can to get a real chance at you want to get a pretty good size goal difference. So if there's any ties in there for whatever reason, you can find yourself with a much better goal difference. Now into the middle, turn. Now a turn, a left-footed shot caught by Moeller. Matt Moeller has been He's the reason this game is only 3-0. He's made plenty of, he's made a lot of saves and a lot of very good saves to keep this Miege Stags team semi in this game. That previous shot by Johnny Munoz on the left foot. And now they're going to drive back up the field, Olathe West. It's in the back of the net. Olathe West gets another goal. This one scored by number 18, Elijah Ochoa. And it's 4-0. Olathe West, they have taken control of this ball game and made it 4. This is a fourth different goal scorer. This one is Elijah Ochoa, the junior, finding the back of the net for the Owls here with 22:39 to play in this ball game. So now Miege continue to show some fight here, down 4-0, here against their Sunflower opponent, Olathe West. Now out, this ball will be out for a goal kick for Olathe West. And now, oh, another chance in on goal and a whistle and a foul on Olathe West. Now up the wing. Now going back forward. Now they'll play it back into the middle. Out wide will be flicked, but it ran onto by Olathe West. That is Ochoa up this wing. Drives to the byline, drives it across, flicked on. Gets all the way through, no touches. Goes all the way through and will be gathered on the far side by Bishop Miege. Was nearly 5-0. And now it'd be kicked out for a throw in on the far side for the Stags. Flicked on. But play made out for a throw-in for West. And now here comes some substitutions for Olathe West. Or a substitution for Olathe West. Whistle and a foul on Olathe West. It'll be free kick. Now long free kick claim by Sauter. And now he'll throw it out on the to the far side. is kicked out for a throw for Olathe West. Pushing forward for West. Now, tried to hook up a pass there. And now another chance. Going up, now they'll cross it in and be deflected off of Bishop Miege for a St. Thomas Aquinas corner. On the far side of the field, a corner for... Check that, that's not a corner, it was off of Olathe West. Now they'll boot it away. It's up in the air. Two Miege players jump for it. Neither one of them made contact with the ball. And now it's all the way back to the keeper for the Owls. Gonna push forward. Now it's deflected out. Number 23, John Joe Lopez deflects that one out. Now up the wing again, Bessie. And Bessie showing his pace, now cuts in on the right foot. Now we'll play a pass in behind, a through ball. Flicked around. That ball was looking for Johnny Munoz, who has looked extremely, extremely dangerous here in this second half. And now out for a corner. It looks like a... little bit of an injury and a couple substitutions. It'll be a throw in for Olathe West, not a corner, a throw. Looks like they'll take a long throw. And they will. Into the middle will be headed out. And now one back and played back into the middle. Flicked on Matt Moeller with another catch. On a, just a flick shot. And now they'll boot it up the field. Headed on by Peterson. Now they'll come out here to the near side. That's on... Angel Sanchez. Sanchez beats a man, plays it into the middle. Shot by Munoz, spilled by the keeper. What kept out by Miege. What a run by Angel Sanchez. Played it into the middle to Munoz, whose shot was saved. But Moeller had it slip out of his hands and was nearly put into the back of the net. 16 minutes to play. Olathe West 4. Bishop Miege nothing. Into the middle, spin. Spins around. Now trying to beat it. And a battle for the ball. One out of there by Miege. And now Lewis, Jaden Lewis, looking for Hagen, who is battled with. And the ball is flicked out by Cameron Denton. And now a near disaster in the back. And now they're pushing up the field. And they're that guy back into the box. Turnaround shot. Munoz takes the right-footed shot. It's flicked up in. Now a shot on the volley. Going for the corner just off the mark. Oh, Angel Sanchez nearly missed the top corner of the goal. And it's out for a goal kick. Sanchez nearly had that ball curling into the top corner. And it was nearly 5-0. Gallo booted away. And now back on the attack is the Owls. To the near side, and I'll cross it into the middle. Flicked up in the air. Moeller, oh, he had to go make that catch to keep from an own goal. It was nearly a disaster. And now they'll boot it deep. Peterson now flicks it on. An offside flag comes up on Bishop Miege. Oh, and then the free kick taken. Not a good one. Now in the middle, Hagen. Hagen will play it out to Lewis, but intervention by the defense. That is Smotherman, who smothers the offensive player. Now running up the near side. That is Sanchez, and now the ball stays in. But Olathe West, now we'll play it back to the middle of the field. And now Peterson. Peterson, who's got a goal today. Here we go, and now a sliding challenge foul. Free kick. So now a free kick. Now he'll fire it on in the middle, headed on by a Miege defender, and it's going to go out for a corner. Corner kick coming for Olathe West with 12 minutes to play. It's on. Now it'll be kicked out again. This one onto the baseball field. Be a corner kick. And some substitutions coming now for the Owls. Now fires it in, into the box. Now taken out. Thank you. Now a long throw for Olathe West. Shot fired, now headed out. Now Olathe West. Now up the wing, now fires to the middle, Kernow, oh, nearly another goal. Kernow. Kernow's cross to Munoz nearly ended up in another goal. It in. Now into the middle. Now free kick after the foul here, 8 minutes to play. Now crosses it in, looking for man, but it's out for a goal kick. Back on the attack, and now pushing forward, taken away but lost again. Now flicks it on, headed out. Now Peterson takes a shot. Peterson's shot saved by Muller. Peterson tried for a second. Blake Peterson with a strike from outside the box, and it nearly ended up in the back of the net. Jaden Lewis loses the ball. And now they'll fire up the field to Hagen. Garrett Hagen. Now he'll flick it on. It'll be a chance. And the ball is won. And it's in the back of the net. Goal scored for Bishop Miege by number 7, Victor Lopez. Victor Lopez pounces on the loose ball and pokes it past the keeper and into the back of the net. And it's a goal for Bishop Miege, and it's 4-1. Cornell shot high and over the bar. Cornell shot just over the bar. 4-1 with 6 minutes to play. Bishop Miege just pulled one back to make it 4-1 here on 810varsity.com. Game three of our day. Game four coming up between Dodge City and St. Thomas Aquinas. First two games, as I mentioned a little bit ago, it was a Blue Valley North 4-0 victory over Lee Summit North. Blue Valley Southwest had a 1-0 victory over Lee Summit West. And this match, and nearly a fifth again. And this game, 4-1, is our score. Olathe West all over Bishop Miege so far. But Miege has just scored the latest goal. And so now a bunch of substitutions, it appears, coming for Olathe West. And now they'll play another ball on now. Just flicked on by Miege. Controlled. And taken by Miege. Going to go back the other way. Fires it on. Looking for Jaden Lewis. Lewis nearly runs onto it. And now that ball is booted out for now a bunch of substitutions for Olathe West with 4:22 left in this ball game. Olathe West has the 4-1 lead. Field. And now fired ahead. Lewis. Jaden Lewis pushed and fouled. Time that's going to be a red card for Olathe West. Interesting developments here with the straight red card for the foul on Jaden Lewis, who has looked to be on his way in on goal. And so, I mean, it's the right call. And so now down to 10 men is Olathe West. And Bishop Miege has the ball on the edge of the box. Here, 4:02 to play in the ball game. Miege still down 3 goals. The shot on the free kick is just over the bar and out for a goal kick. As the wind was blowing pretty hard earlier, it looks like it's died down just a little bit here as we're getting ready for the late game tonight. And now they're going to push up the field, try to find a couple more, at least 2 more goals, if not more. And it looks like an injury in the middle of the field for Bishop Miege. Player gets up and is trying to run it off now, trying to play it through the back. Hagen up the wing, trying to get into the middle. That's taken away, and a foul on Garrett Hagen. Free kick. Now shot taken, saved by Moeller. Ball is out for a throw-in. So a minute and a half to play here on 810varsity.com. The first game of the two that we are broadcasting here live from St. Thomas Aquinas. And now they're going to, Miege trying to get another goal back, pushing forward against just the 10 men of Olathe West. Now plays it here to the near side. Lewis trying to find a cross. Now he'll spin back, play it, but a little bit of skill back to the middle. And now Olathe West under a minute to play. Now they'll bomb it forward. Kernow. Now him against the keeper, and the ball didn't go real far there. And they'll win it back. And now Miege trying to push back the other way. Jaden Lewis. Lewis showing his pace off. Here to the near side. Shot. Back post. Ah, saved by Sauter. And nothing doing. And so that will most certainly do it here from the first game of the 8-10 varsity. Final score, Olathe West 4, Bishop Miege 1. Our final game will be at 7 o'clock between Dodge City and St. Thomas Aquinas. And so we will take a break and come back for it here in a little bit here on 810 Varsity. com.
Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Check. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Sweet.
Wake Forest. We went out. We take Clemson's spot. This is. I tried to.
You got a good idea what we're doing.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I think the other guys is going. That's what Chad was going to say.
All right. Well, it works.
Starting lineup for Columbus. Nothing, though. He's not. He's late, so they can start in his place.
Is that Eames? Eames?
Eames.
Alright. Stockland, Schroeder, Muckerman, Farrar, Kids, Welch, White. I guess that went back a little bit.
It's not a.
You know about Dodge City?
A bunch of weird names.
Yeah, I saw that. Carlos Sanchez, Christopher Velas, Daniel Herrera, Moises Esquivel.
When PA guy gets back,
we're going to ask him what he got.
I'd say Canelo. I don't know if the N will be pronounced.
This is one of my Spanish classes.
Rojas, Lopez.
This one's Santiago Asenjo.
Oliveras, Del Real, Aquia, Poki, Duran, Galen, Sanchez, Alberto, Buendia, Iglesias, Cabrera, Jacinto. Bang, bang.
Yeah.
Their best goalkeeper is back tonight.
Really?
Yeah.
That should make things interesting.
Yeah.
Which one is that?
In Congo.